there. Hey there, Nanners. I heard someone's got a birthday. And I've been doing my little research here. I decided to research April 23rd, 1940. 80 years ago. Gosh. You'd never know. You'd never know. Looking good, Nanny. Looking good, Nanners. All right. So this is what I came up with. You were born on a Tuesday, and you're of, as you know, you're a Taurus. April 23rd, Tuesday, 1940. And the U.S. president was Franklin D. Roosevelt, who was a Democrat. And the famous people born on this day are names we don't know and can't pronounce, so we don't care. My favorite wife, directed by Garson Cannon, if I'm saying that correctly, was one of the most viewed movies released in 1940 on TV. I didn't know people had TV in 1940. Goodness gracious. And people are watching NBC News. People still watch that today. Some, the 1940 TV series, it says. But much more happened that day. But we're going to move on to a different link. And in April 23rd, 1940. Let's see what we got here. Well, we can't get the specifics of that date right here. But what we can get right here is the 1940s. Let's see. What major world events happened in 1940? The July 5th of 1940, which was after you were born. There was the Battle of Britain. And that was, that's the only thing they showed us. Everything else is after the 40. Let me see here. What toys were popular in the 1940s? Electric football. Erector set. Well, that sounds interesting. Erector. What are they talking about? Electric football. Erector set. Diecast toys. Interesting. And then there was the photo with an F. O-T-O, electric football. Well, Jacob's ladder. Oh, I have a Jacob's ladder. Oh my gosh, I got one of those. It's so fun. It's just not big enough to climb to the roof, but it works just to have fun. It was from the Johnson Smith Company. Labyrinth, the Lincoln Logs, Lionel Trains. Remember any of these things? The Magic 8-Ball was a toy from... Gosh, I got one of those too! Gosh, I'm a 40s chick. Marbles! Lost a lot of those over my years. Mickey Mouse, Monopoly. Parcheesi, pickup sticks. A pogo stick! You used to have a pogo stick at your house. I remember when I was a kid, I used to try to hop on it and I always fell off. And it's probably why I'm such an airhead. I probably bumped my head. Anyways, the Radio Flyer Wagon, Raggedy Ann, I got those too. I got a Radio Flyer Wagon and I got a Raggedy Ann. I'm such an old soul. Scrabble, we played Scrabble tonight. Oh my gosh, we are 1940 screaming over here. Holy nuts. Silly Putty, Slinky. I've got all these things. Goodness gracious. Well, I have my Silly Putty. I don't have any of that right now, but I had it not too long ago. What was invented in anything invented in 1940? All right, top song in 1940 was White Christmas by Bing Crosby. Well, that fits the situation right now because it feels like Christmas week for the past week. I almost went out and went did some Christmas shopping, and then I realized I couldn't because of Corona. And then it's not Christmas time. That was the bigger problem because there's always Target, Walmart, you know. Anyways. Oh, the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. The Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy accompany me. I like that song too. One of my favorites. Stardust. And you could be swinging on a star. Would you like to? All right. You always hurt the one you love. Well, that is not very nice. I don't know that song, so I can't sing it. God Bless the Child. I don't know the words to that one either. The Christmas Song. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire by Nat King Cole. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Let me see. Well, oh, dances. We'll wrap this up in a minute here. The dances that were popular in the 1940s was the Roger Rabbit. Oh, I'm sorry. That was the 1990s. All right. I'm just joking. In the 1940s was swing. You guys were a bunch of swingers back in the 40s, and you guys all act like you were prim and proper back then. And you guys were all swinging all around. So, that's what you guys were doing in the 1940s, swinging, ding-a-dinging, and dancing, swinging and dancing. The Jive, the Big Apple, West Coast Swing. They swung on the West Coast, they swung on the East. The Whip, what is that? The Whip, that sounds a little bit kinky. The Push, goodness. The Whip, the Push, they're swinging. Goodness gracious, and they, in the 1940s, they were more wild than we ever knew. And on the East Coast, swing were referred to as the jitterbug dance. Wake me up before you go-go. Jitterbug. And what was the one more thing? What was going, oh, two more things. What was going on in America in 1940 was the USA entered World War II. At the end of 41, after the attack on Pearl Harbor, and Roosevelt took a stand as a strong leader when the U.S. joined the Allies in Europe. FDR died in early 1945 while in office. We're past 1940. We're not, it's not a history lesson on anything beyond 1940. All right. And last but not least, prices. What was the price of gas in 1945? Well, you want 1940. Oh, goodness. Well, 1940 for gas isn't showing. Did they have gas yet? I'm sure they did. But 1945, 5 years later, it was so expensive. I don't know how people afforded to even go to the corner for a soda, 21 cents a gallon. That is ridiculous. Holy cow, we could buy gas left and right nowadays with that. How much did a loaf of bread cost in the 1940s? It says cost of a gallon of gas was 10 cents. Average cost for a house was $26 a month to rent a house. Holy crap! They could be living in a mansion for nowadays if it was still so cheap like that. My gosh. Loaf of bread, 9 cents? It's cheaper to buy it than to make it. Pound of hamburger meat was 12 cents? Wow, you guys, we had it made back in the 1940s. Anyways, oh, eggs. Gotta know. Got eggs. Oh, you have to know. Eggs. Goodness. 33 cents a dozen. 33 cents a dozen. So cheap. We have burger. How much did a burger cost in 1940? Gosh. You know, you must be old when eggs were 33 cents a dozen when you were born. I'm just kidding. 12 cents. What are we? Oh, goodness. Hang on now. There's all these cents in years. I can't. 20 cents. 20 cents for a burger. Could you believe that? It's only about 80 to 90 cents more now for the cheap stuff. I think. I don't know. I don't buy burgers in a while. Well, butter. Before the days of parquet. How much did butter cost in 1940? I don't know. It doesn't really tell me. I think it's saying 36 cents. 36 cents and for some butter. Gosh. Anyways, milk. That was the last one I was looking for. Hourly wage. Well, this just keeps getting good. Oh my gosh. No wonder why everything was so cheap. You only made 30 cents an hour for minimum wage. Gosh, can't even buy toilet paper for that. You can't buy toilet paper even if you've got more than that.
You have to work for a month just to afford that glass of wine right there.
Exactly. I'm glad I make more than 30 cents an hour. I'm not making anything though right now. Thanks, Corona. So, minimum wage, 30 cents. We got everything but our milk. Gosh darn it all, where's the price of my milk? Tammy Lynn, I can't find the milk.
Was there even a McDonald's back then?
I don't know. Should we research that? Heck with the milk. Let's find out if there was a McDonald's. Someone probably knows that. Someone's watching this and they're like, well, duh. When?
Well, they started with like 19-cent hamburgers.
McDonald's open. No Mickey D's. That came 15 years later in San Bernardino, California. San Bernardino. Well, I don't know where you bought your burgers. Maybe you made them. I know you made them. But I don't know where you bought a burger. Where did you buy a burger? You buy a burger in Punk Sioux Tawny, PA, 1948, because you were born in Punxsutawney, not Buffalo. See, I remembered that. I remembered. I searched the right city. Oh, wait, what was the first menu of McDonald's in 1940? McDonald's was around in 1940, just not in San Bernardino. Oh, wow. This is exciting. French fries was the first menu item at McDonald's in 1940. How about that? Who would ever thunk it? That's exciting. So, McDonald's is older than you are. First thing sold at McDonald's. No, it's saying, I don't know. Anyways, so I guess you bought a burger at McDonald's when you were born. Maybe Grandpa bought one on the way home from the hospital that night. Who knows? But McDonald's burger was only 15 cents. Dang. I think that's cheaper than a gumball nowadays. Anyways, Nanners, happy birthday. I'll be back in a little bit with a special little treat just for you.